This is Styles FM.
Portlanders, Acan Auto Technology, located at 33 Bomber Crescent, Port Antonio. Visit us for all your auto repair and servicing. We offer computerized wheel alignment, computerized wheel balancing, suspension checks, AC repair, inspection, and all your auto repair needs. For a complete auto repair and service, visit or call Acan Auto Technology today at 715-5205. And remember, we are located at 33 Bonbrook Crescent.
Remember Styles FM on social media. View us on YouTube, Styles FM Radio. Follow us on Instagram at Styles FM. Like us on Twitter at Styles FM 961. Become a fan on Facebook, Styles FM 96.1.
Styles FM, the People's Station, is now on your radio. 96.1 and 96.7 on your FM band.
Tell a friend to tell a friend. Styles FM, your northeastern radio station based in Portland, Jamaica. Tune in now.
Hi, this is Leroy Gibbon passing through saying, you're listening to Sista P on the Spiritual Vibration Show. Sista P, you know what? Just love how you send it across to them culturally, you know. Send it to them same way because them need it, Sista P. Leroy Gibbon, say so.
Some things we want to talk about this morning. First of all, United States President Barack Obama is set to visit Jamaica next month. And every time that I hear President Obama's name, I always get sort of, I don't know, I guess I'm at a loss for words, because the Jamaican government, the party, that party wears orange. And it's a real party, you know, like with music and dancing and all of that stuff. And then the JLP, the ones who wear green, another party. Yeah, because it's all a party. Nothing to do with governance. Both of them like the President of the United States. So what does that tell you? What that tells me is that they're one and the same. Same thing. No make no difference. And while we're on that subject, the other day a lady was talking to me and she said, Sista P, you know that a woman come to me and said to me, why am I wearing green? Because she's not supposed to wear green because she belongs to the orange bunch, that tribe. So she said, but you can't tell me what to wear. So the woman said to her, and why are you talking to the woman next to you? Because the woman is a labor right. So first of all, you're not supposed to wear green because he's a PNP. And the next one, you're not supposed to be talking to the next one because the next one is a labor right. So the woman turned to her and said, oh, you mean me mustn't talk to my sister? Me and my sister don't have a problem. No, you tell me, Jamaican people. Me as an intelligent person. Is that something for me to be a part of? Can I be a part of something like that that is a detriment to Jamaican people? If I become a part of that, do me a favor, can I go to Bellevue? Because I would totally be insane. I would be mad. Or I might be smoking crack cocaine or something, because nothing in my being can tell me that I should have followed something like that. That don't make no sense to me. Them there's something, you know what, dibby dibby? That's a dibby dibby. Yes. So anyway, I can imagine when President Obama come here, you know, and you see everybody dressed, he's only going to be here for one day. I wonder how much they're going to spend for buy the next suit for the day. The man not even going to see them because he's only going to be here, but everybody want to go and shake his hand and everybody want to see him. He not even member, you know. And he's nobody. He not even member, you know. Next thing I want to talk about, since one of my sisters, one of my listeners was in Jamaica, you know the thing would turn off Jamaican people that live overseas when them come home? Now for only two beggy. Tell me something, you don't give these people nothing in foreign that when them come, you expect something? Sometimes people want to come back to Jamaica, but them say, Lord, I'm a Sister P, me can't come there, the people them beg too much. You never give the people them nothing. You never give them nothing. Them owe you something. And then she was even telling me the case now of this girl that gone up to her husband, chatting up to her husband, and begging the husband because she's 9 months pregnant and the man left her. Is for him problem that? I know for him problem that. Woman, no phone out there. Lock up on your foot, no? Lock up on your legs, no? Tell me something. When you go and have, you're not on birth control. Because some people don't like that. So when you catch up somewhere with some man and have a picnic, why that picnic must become the government problem or other people problem? Tell me something. You never have a plan. If you don't have a plan, it can't work, you know. You have to have a plan. So if the plan is to have a picnic, to have unprotected sex, to have a picnic, make it be your problem. Do not make it be society problem. That is your problem. But this thing about begging Jamaican people when they come home to visit. Yes, we have a tradition where you bring two soap. A Jamaican tradition that, you know, when you come from foreign, you bring two soap. And everybody will come. You give them a soap. But then when you're gone, I did a day me in the street and a man come to me and him say, Sister P, sometime, you know, you have some people, you say anytime them come over to me and say, Sister P, you know, say, yeah, my mother, me say, me afraid for them like, puss, me ready for run because me know, say, the next thing will come in. So what, you can't do something for me. Now the man see me. The man show me $1,000 bill in him hand. And then him say, boy, so and so. You can give me $2, Sister P. So what? Him say $2. So when I beg 10 cent no more, $10 no more, $2 people I beg now. So I turn to the man and I say, brethren, you know, say $2 I need to go buy a cylinder of gas for putting in my kitchen. You shut up. You never have nothing more to say. Then this thing with the Riverton dump. Thing about it is that, you see, when we live in Portland, we don't really, the Riverton dump is not in our psyche. We hear about it, we know about it, but it's not something that affects us. But to what I get to understand, this Riverton, like, some people call it a landfill. It is not a landfill. Okay? It is not a landfill. But they call it that. From what I'm watching, all of what is going on with Riverton, the thing should have been closed years ago. Years ago. But each one of them that come in, that said that they are going to carry the country better, none of them paid no mind until the fire then broke out. And when the fire broke out now, everybody run up and down and say, what need to be done? You both had your opportunities. The thing is past its lifetime. An alternative site should have been found a long time ago. Yes. And now they're saying that it is arson. But I saw two women on TV and they were saying, why would we set this thing on fire? Because this is what we use to send our children to school. We even have university students that we are sending to school by living off of the dump. But the bottom line is, the thing should have been closed years ago. Years ago. But nobody don't pay it no mind. And when I don't have this on my list, but I will want to talk about it. What's happening to the taxi drivers with the transport authority? Every day it's a new rule. Every day it's a new tax. And guess what? All them do is talk about it. That's all them do, talk about it. You see any other country, it wouldn't be so. But sometimes I have to mind my own business. Because I can't understand how them the kind of pressure come down upon people and then just take it. Maybe because I went through the civil rights movement when we never did take it. And if we did take it, might be people wouldn't be calling themselves dog and nigger and all of those things. Might be if we did take it, I don't know. Then you see where this man molest a 12-year-old girl and make her pregnant. And the man is a 52-year-old relative of hers. And it's when she was coming home from school from extra lessons that he molest her and make her pregnant, 12 years old. Then hear the end of the story now. However, police officers who are investigating the case said they delayed taking the man into custody because his foot had been recently amputated. In other words, and just recently cut off his foot. So what, me if I feel sorry for him? Me if I feel sorry for him? What do you mean they make the foot rotten off? Because at least he won't have no chance to molest nobody else. And last but not least, then lock up a Chinaman. You know what him do? Him bring in fake name brand shoes into Jamaica. $50 million worth. So I know the whole devil of name brand. I let me know that now go catch me, you know, coming in the name brand business. Because any name brand when me wear, they have to pay me for wear that. Me not going to put on nothing on no t-shirt, clothes, nothing that have nobody name on there and me not getting paid for it. The only name brand when me wear is when me put on the styles ID around my neck. Because I know me benefit from that. And at least me can advertise styles. But you see all them necks sitting there, so all Aero pasta, all them sitting there, so I pay them a dollar for pay me for wear that. That is advertising. So I'm going to say, why me must give them free advertising? Them living in a mansion, driving Rolls Royce, and me they advertise for them like an idiot. That not going to work. People, get real now. Just try and understand. Might be we're trying to understand. Try and understand how the world work. They might use, you know, free advertising. When you see your brethren, you know, one of them with the name brand, you left that now and you gone. Boy, me if you have one of that. And them keep getting rich and richer and richer. And you keep getting poorer and poorer. Because guess what? When they go on TV or on radio, they have to pay. But when you wear it, they don't have to pay you. Because you don't even understand the system yet. Maybe we need to start understanding what is happening in the world.
You're tuned in to Spiritual Vibration with Sista P.
say a blessed good morning to our Splash Radio listeners here in New Jersey. Also to Denise and Anna Kay and Dario. Hold up, man. By tomorrow or, let's say, 2 months' time, it will be nothing. So just hold your head up high and give thanks. Give thanks, at least.
We're a survivor.
Easy, schism, game, dine, and go to heaven in Jesus' name.
Yes, D. Brown.
Yeah, I remember that movement, what started.
Not hearing you so well.
Now you hear me now?
Yes, uh-huh.
You remember that movement, what started a few days ago, what they called Mount Those Farmers, what?
What they did, what?
Those farmers.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you remember those farmers, what, they started something good a few months ago?
Yes, uh-huh.
So, I would like to know, I would like you to find what's out there if there's anything.
Okay, I can tell you that Odain Scott is doing very well. He even brought pumpkin for me. The other two that are in Clear Spring, they continue to farm. I know that they always have callaloo. They always have something to sell, peppers, whatever. One of them, I have to admit, was a disappointment. He left Portland and went back to his space in St. Catherine, where he came from. However, they passed it on to another farmer. So what I will do is I will try to get you a definite update.
No, I don't want an update. I just want to find out if there's anything I can ask for what I already done.
Okay, I will find out from them. Definitely find out from them, D. Brown. And thank you ever so much.
I'm still the same person. As what I said before, I'm not a politician and I'm not a pastor.
Yes, we know that. We know that, D. Brown. I know that what you want to do as a concerned citizen is to assist.
I forget to say, okay, D. Brown, I go on to the MP one night and I have nothing to do with politics. I have nothing to do with any form of religion. So nobody don't have to worry about D. Brown. I go up there.
No, sir. I don't think anybody is thinking that. I think you're just like the many Jamaicans overseas who want to assist. Anyway, Dean Brown, I have to move on here now. All right? And give thanks. We'll be in touch.
You better.